So this first question is, how many subgroups of order 4 does D4 have? If you ever encounter such a question on the test, the first thing you should think about is, okay, does, in this case, D4 have any elements of order 4? That's the first thing you should think about. And we know from some experience with it that R90 and R270 do. The order of R90 and the order of R270 are both 4 as group elements, meaning that's the smallest positive power of these elements that brings you back to the identity, which is R0. Power in this case really means you're not literally multiplying these things because they're functions, but you are composing them. Though the function composition is the group operation, because they have order 4 as group elements, that's also going to mean the cyclic subgroup that they generate has order 4 as a subgroup. It'll have 4 elements. The cyclic subgroup generated by R90. Well, of course, there's R0, which effectively is R90 to the 0 power. There's R90 itself. There's R90 squared, meaning compose R90 with itself, meaning do 2 rotations by 90 degrees, giving you R180. And there's R270 when you compose R90, doing the operation 3 times. Then if you do it 4 times, you could call it R360, but it's equivalent to R0, brings you back to the identity. If you think about R270 and its cyclic subgroup that it generates, you get the exact same thing. I mean, you could write it in the other order. First of all, R270 to the 0 power is R0. To the first power is itself. To the second power is R180. And to the third power is R90. However, as sets, those are the same set, right? This is not like trying to do a permutation in problem stats and counting different orderings as being different. These are the same set. The same set, and therefore the same subgroup of D4. So that's one of the answers. Are there more? Key things you want to think about are, for sure they've got to include R0. For sure they have to have 4 elements. And for sure they have to be closed under both multiplication and inverses. Associativity will automatically happen because it's true in the group overall. So you've got to do some experimentation, perhaps, looking at the Cayley table. We just looked at what's really the cyclic subgroup of all rotations is the one generated by R90 and R270. R180, of course, has order 2. It generates a cyclic subgroup of order 2, not order 4. So that's not going to have order 4. It's going to have to have some of these flips, these reflections, H, V, D, or D prime in them, if we're going to generate another subgroup of order 4. However, any other subgroup of order 4 can't possibly be cyclic. Because, yeah, R90 and R270 are the only elements of order 4. R0 has order 1, that's the identity. R180, and then all the flips have order 2. They're not going to generate cyclic subgroups of order 4. So it's a bit of experimentation. You're looking at the Cayley table. It does seem like the H and V kind of go together. I hope you saw that. And the D and D prime kind of go together. Like, for example, if you compose H with V, you get R180. And V with H, you get R180. But if you compose H with D or D prime, you get these other ones, R90 and R270, that have order 4. It should feel, based on that, like if you started making it, trying to make a subgroup of order 4 and you included H and D, for example, that would be a problem, because when you compose them, you get R90. And then when you want to make a subgroup out of that, you can do higher powers of that. You're going to get R180, R270 as well. It's going to be bigger than order 4. Doesn't that feel like a problem? Did you catch what I said? If you compose H with D, you get R90. That means H times D in the group. is R90. But then if you square that, you get R180. If you cube it, you get R270. And you're gonna get more than four elements. You're gonna get the entire group, really, if H and D are also in this subgroup together. Same with H and D prime. But H and V compose to R180, and R180 squares back the identity. You're not getting more elements when you square and cube and et cetera. So maybe that should, you know, make alarm bells go off in your mind. Maybe if we include R0, R, H and V, and R180, maybe that's a subgroup order four. We're not really proving it, but let's give it a try. Let H equal, I'll call it H1. Maybe I should call it something different since H represents a horizontal reflection. What should I call it? What other letter? How about J? J1. If J1 consists of R0, R180, H, and V, it's got R0. It's got four elements. Initially, looking at that Cayley table, seems like maybe this would be closed. We haven't proved that, but maybe it would be closed. Let's go ahead and try to make a full Cayley table. Each element's inverse is in here. That's for sure, because each element is its own inverse. Each element besides the identity has order two. The identity has order one. They're all their own inverses. The only thing questionable is closure. Let's go ahead and make a Cayley table here, a sub-Cayley table of the bigger one, to see if closure is satisfied or not. R0 is the identity, so we can quickly fill in those parts. Every element has order two, so along the main diagonal, you're going to get a bunch of R0s, the identity. In the Cayley table we just looked at, the bigger one, we saw that H composed with V in either order was R180. So the only question left is, what is R180 composed with H and V? Do I stay within this set? Do I, for example, is R180 composed with H equal to V? It should be. If this is going to be a subgroup, let's take a peek. I mean, you can try drawing a picture to see if you can figure it out, but R180 composed with H is V right there. And R180 composed with V is H. And it works the other way around too. H composed with R180 is V. V composed with R180 is H. So we are staying within the set under composition. It is closed under the operation of function composition. You can make a Cayley table like this and argue that because of this, it's closed, as long as you've done the computations right. We're relying on the bigger Cayley table. So that's a non-cyclic subgroup of order four. A non-cyclic subgroup of D4 with order four. Are there other non-cyclic subgroups of order four? Remember, there's only one cyclic subgroup generated by R90 and R270 of order four is what I'm talking about. There's actually lots of cyclic subgroups, though. All the ones generated by elements of order two are cyclic subgroups as well, but there's only one cyclic subgroup of order four. Are there any other non-cyclic subgroups of order four? If we look back at the Cayley table, we'd see that D and D prime kind of go together as well. I won't show it again, but D composed with D prime is R180, and D prime composed with D is R180. R0, R180, D and D prime. I won't make the Cayley table, but this is another non-cyclic subgroup of D4 with order four. Are we done? Are there any more non-cyclic subgroups of D4 that have order 4? D4 has order 8. We're talking about subgroups of order 4. No, there aren't. Because if you try mixing H's with D's, for example, or V with D, what I mentioned a few minutes ago is a problem as far as generating a subgroup of order 4. I'll say it again. H composed D is R90. So if you try to include H and D and R0 in a subgroup of order 4, you'd also have to include R90 in there, but then you'd also have to include R90 squared, which is R180, and R90 cubed, which is R270. It would be bigger than order 4. In fact, I'm not proving it, but you could prove it's the entire group. H and D prime leads to a similar problem. V and D leads to a similar problem. V composed with D is R270. V composed with D prime is R90. We're getting these extra elements that have order 4. We're going to get a sub bigger than order 4 if we try to include all these things. So it does seem like the H and V kind of go together in some way, and D prime kind of go together, which makes some intuitive sense because you think about the reflections. H is a reflection about the horizontal and V about the vertical. And the D and V prime are about diagonal reflections. So maybe because of that, that's why they're kind of tied together. It's not a proof of anything, but it's some intuition. If you try to include R0, R90 with H and V, that would be a problem as well. Because, for example, H composed V is R180. You're getting more elements still. No matter what you try to do, you're not going to get another cyclic or non-cyclic subgroup of order 4. So overall, then, it looks like there are three subgroups of order 4, the cyclic one and two non-cyclic ones.